we are going to move on lastly to water power. Got a feeling it could get a little bit messy in the studio. Water power, also known as hydropower.
Right, so hydropower is energy that comes from moving water. If ever you've seen a river flowing fast down a hill, or maybe a waterfall, or even waves crashing into the shore, then you'll know that moving water has lots of energy.
Yeah, so just like wind power, people have been using this hydropower, the power of water, for thousands of years.
So over 2,000 years ago, people were using water to run water mills to do things like grind wheat to make flour. Nowadays, we use flowing water to spin a turbine to generate electricity.
Look at this picture here. This is a tidal energy plant.
Yes.
And each day the sea comes in and out, and we call that the tide.
Right.
And as the tide comes in and out, that moving water spins these underwater turbines.
Yeah.
And I think it looks like an underwater wind turbine that you can try at home if you want to.
It's a good one.
To show you how to harness the power of water, it is a model water wheel.
Yes.
Here's how you make it. You need yourself a bottle, and then find yourself some card. So these are actually index cards, but you could use birthday cards or just a bit of card. Chop them up into square. We covered them in cling film to make them waterproof, and we just held the cling film down with a bit of sticky tape. Now, this is where you'll need to get a grown-up to help out, to make some slits in the bottle. Five slits for the five paddles, and then you push the these paddles into those slits. All right. Next up, you need to make a hole at the bottom. Get a grown up to help you with that. That's quite tricky. You did a grand job.
I used a drill.
Yeah. Then you need to grab yourself a Michael cane. Little joke. You need to grab yourself a cane or a stick.
Garden cane.
A garden stick.
Michael cane.
That fits through through the hole at the back and through the front like this. And then last but not least, attach a string to the front with a weight. You could weight this with whatever you want, some coins or some blue tack or whatever. Full instructions, of course, in the video description below this video.
But the question is, will our water wheel turn? And will it be able to lift the weight that we've attached to the bottle?
Bigger question, I think, is this a good idea to do in our spare room studio with microphones and stuff around? No, it isn't. But hey, we're going to try it.
What we want to do is we want to turn the water wheel, and we're going to try and raise the bottle cap up and down. Okay, you ready for this?
Hang on, let me do it so they can see the close-up like this, because then that'll work quite nicely.
Okay.
Oh, that works.
Over the tub. Right?
Oh my goodness.
Ready?
Are we over the tub?
I hope so.
Don't drip it! Yay! That worked so well!
Look, did you see? So you want to keep an eye on the bottle cap. It's the bottle cap that we want to
Should we unwind it again?
There we go, it's unwound. You're winding it up again. There we go. Unwind once more. Here we go.
Go for it. Oh, that's my foot!
Oh my god, we're holding it at a dodgy angle. Let me hold it, there we go.
Okay, we're ready, go.
Yay!
Okay, stop! The floor is soaking wet.